Welcome back to the second and final part of our series on El Nido in Palawan, where a full morning spent lounging, fishing, kayaking, and picnicking on the islands makes you realize why most travel publications and websites around the world list the beaches of El Nido among the best in the planet. What those travel writers fail to mention, however, is that the experience can even be more magical when spent in the privacy of an exclusive beachfront lounge, such as those owned by Lihim, El Nido's newest luxury resort. Of course, you can also explore some of the other islands that are open to the public. Just make sure to time your visit. Not too many tourists and day trippers are around to ruin the experience. For swimming and lounging, few public beaches can beat Nakpan with its powdery white sand and clear shallow waters. You actually get two beachfronts and separate views in one if you cross over by foot to adjoining Kalitang. Less known to tourists but equally great for swimming is Papaya Beach. A wonderful spot as well for snorkeling without a boat, since the coral reefs are so close to the beachfront. My personal favorite among the public beaches is Snake Island. Like so many of the islands named after their unique shapes, this beach gets its name from the distinct S shape of its sandbar. Another popular destination named after its shape is Helicopter Island because, well, it looks like a chopper from afar. And speaking of unusually named islands, Shimizu takes after a Japanese scuba diver, Shimizu-san, who was trapped in an underwater cave and whose body was found on this island days after. Or so the legend goes. Indeed, it's backstories like these that add to the mystique of El Nido's legendary islands. None more so than Pinagbuyutan, which skyrocketed to global fame after several versions of the Survivor reality TV show were filmed here.
That was a lot of fun, but not all the adventure happens on the islands. In fact, a lot of fun happens on the mainland as well. But before we get to that, let me just cool off at the dockyard.
Can I have a San Miguel here?
So let me just cool off while I wait for my ride. Apparently, a lot of Lihim guests hang out here.
Bad, most tourists overlook both the natural and man-made attractions of the mainland. For nature trippers with endurance and climbing skills, the scenery of El Nido Town and Buckwheat Bay from atop the craggy peak of Tarao Cliff is up there with the best of any mountaintop view in the Philippines. It's breathtaking. Literally, too. The town itself, and especially the nightlife, is fast becoming the next big thing after Boracay and Siargao. So catch it before it's entirely gentrified.
Mm-hmm.
mainland of El Nido is also where Palawan's mountains and rainforests meet the sea. Lihim is building an adventure zone in the middle of the forest for guests to experience a different side of El Nido up in the mountains.
El Nido's beaches and islands deserve its world-class status, but less people realize that the mountains and rainforests of Palawan are just as majestic. Now, the best way to experience that is with an ATV, an all-terrain vehicle.
Although the visitor's lounge is still under construction, and so is the rest of the mountain trail that snakes through the forest, I was able to get a sneak peek at what will be an off-roading circuit when the project is completed later this year. Lucky for me, the ground was dry as the rainy season hadn't started yet, because when wet, you'll need better off-roading driving skills to get through the deep mud and slippery slopes of the forest trail safely.
Ooh, that was hot. I need a drink. Thanks, Jessica. Oh, nice. My name's on it. Okay, that was just a sneak preview of where you can go and what you can see. But when the ATV track is finalized, it will actually go through a much longer journey and through more interesting jungle terrain. In fact, when this place is done, it'll be an events place for guests of Lihim.
When completed, the area can also be used for glamping in the forest. Though, unlike the seaside resort, you won't get a good view of El Nido's iconic sunset. For that, you'll want to take a late afternoon cruise on board Lihim's large pleasure boat.
Pleasure is what you call a pleasure boat. It was built for the pleasure of guests, whether it's a floating cocktail party or an intimate sunset cruise.
Although built like a native outrigger on steroids, the smooth and steady ride of pleasure feels like being on the deck of a super yacht with more than enough space for a large dinner setup, cocktail bar, and even a dance floor for partying after dark. There won't be any partying for me this time, however, since I'm alone on this trip. But I love having all this space to myself so I can find the perfect angle to view the setting sun on the bay, which in El Nido is always so mystical, a transcendental scene provided by the bay's ancient limestone silhouette. It's my final night in Lihim, and I'm told to expect one last secret before I leave the next morning.
I must say, Lihim, they really love secrets. You know, last night my dinner was at this hidden wine cellar underneath one of the villas. And tonight they say it's somewhere up here behind a door. I bet that's the one. It has no sign, but I bet that's the one. This is the bunker. No, it's you again. Okay, this must be the bunker, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Come in, please.
Okay. Wow. It's not exactly a bunker. It's more like a whiskey room. Let's see.
I guess they call this a bunker because it is one. A speakeasy-style whiskey and cigar lounge that's built underground and hidden from sight. Indeed, with a fine selection of whiskies, cognacs, gins, and other spirits from the best producers around the world, I really wouldn't mind sitting out a disaster in this soundproof and climate-controlled bunker. Like the previous nights, dinner tonight is off the menu. sort of like omakase, which depends on what's available, in season, or what the chef wants to serve me.
Wow, chef. Yeah. You're taking your secret menu a bit too far. So what's the secret underneath this?
So, we have fish papillon, so you need to open it.
So it's like a wrap.
Yes.
How do you open it? Just wrap, tear it up.
Tear it.
Okay, so it's salmon. Okay, that's the secret.
Yeah.
Revealed. Okay, I'm gonna enjoy this.
I'm really tempted to relax in the bunker with a glass of whiskey or two. But being my last night in El Nido, I wanted to spend a bit more time enjoying the nighttime view. So thanks again to my butler. The massage I requested was organized as scheduled. After an active day on the beach and up in the mountains, it's time to slow down, relax, and reward my weary body with some expert pampering before I sleep. Departing from a paradise like El Nido is always so difficult to do. You don't want to ruin the last hours in heaven by rushing while packing and checking out. Here in Lihim, your butler and the rest of the staff will do all that for you.
So my bags are packed and I'm ready to leave, but with just a bit of time left to dwell on all those blissful memories here before heading home.